Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. Today we are going to check the image function. It was released sometime back in Excel and it has changed the way Excel handles images. Let me show you what I mean by that. Here we have two identical sheets. They have names of the countries with their population, area in kilometer square, and their respective flags. Both the sheets have the same data and the images of the flags have been taken from this link here and from flagpedia.net. Let's check on this sheet here, the first one. And let's say we wish to sort these countries not by their population, but by their name. So we apply filters on the top here, Control Shift L. And now let's go to this dropdown and choose this option. And what do we have here? Most of our images are not where they were. Germany and Russia are missing. And I think France and Ukraine have two flags on top of each other. Let's undo this and check the other sheet. Let's do the same thing here. Apply filters and choose to sort. And this works flawlessly. But why is that? I'll give you the simplest reason of all. In our first sheet, the images are what is known as placed over the cells, meaning they are not attached to any cell. They can be moved like this to any other place and they can be resized. While on this sheet, the images are part of the cell they are in, like a value or formula that you mention in a cell. Just like when you write a value in any cell, you can refer to that cell by its row and column number, you can now do the same with images placed inside a cell. This is made possible by the updated options in handling images in Excel. In this sheet, I have used the image formula. Let me show you its syntax. Source is the link of the image. In our case, it's the link in the last cell against each country. Just remember, this needs a link which directly refers to an image and will end in supported file formats such as BMP, JPEG, GIF, TIFF, PNG, ICO, and also WebP, which is our format in this sheet. Next is alt text, which is optional and is used to describe the image for accessibility. Then comes sizing, which is again optional and it has four options. 0 will fit the image in the cell and maintain its aspect ratio. 1 will fill the cell with the image, but this option ignores the aspect ratio, so you might get a skewed image. 2 will maintain the original image size, which, if large enough, may exceed the boundary of your cell in Excel. 3 will customize the image size by using the height and width arguments, which comes next. Next argument is height in pixels, and the last argument is width in pixels. Both height and width are optional arguments. So in essence, only the source argument is mandatory to use this function. Rest all the arguments are optional. Now let's try and use the image function with these arguments so as to understand how do they work. Let me delete all the flags from here. By the way, since they are in a cell, you can treat them like any other cell with value or function in it. You can select them all, copy and paste them somewhere else, like this, delete them all and much more. Let's put our sorting order as it was, sorted by the highest population. And now, let's write our image formula here for Russia. For this, we simply use the source and no other arguments. So image, and our source is this cell, so select this and done. I know Russian flag has white on top, it's not visible cause my cell background is also white. If I change the background to something else, you'll be able to check that, like this. For Turkey, let's write our formula. Image, our source is this cell and this time we will use the alt text argument and write flag of Turkey in double quotes. Press enter and we do have the flag, but where is our text? You can view alt text by right clicking on the image and clicking on this option, view alt text. When you do that, you will find that in here, grayed out like this. Let's go to Germany now. Image, select a source from here, let's skip the alt text argument, so comma, and we reach the sizing argument. And let's use 0 here, which will fit the image in the cell by maintaining its aspect ratio. Press enter and here we have our image. Let's move to France. You know what? Let's use the same formula from up here because we simply have to change the sizing argument. So Control D, and now we will choose sizing option number 1, which fills the cells ignoring the aspect ratio. We have the image and it looks the same to me as the one on top. So what's the difference between these two? Image in Germany is maintaining its aspect ratio and image in France is not. They look similar because they are all in the same sized cells. But if I am to increase the column width like this, now see what happens to these images. Same thing will happen if I increase the row height. Since we have used one in our sizing argument, the image will keep trying to fill the cell, ignoring the aspect ratio. Now we have come to the UK, and it's time to use the option 2 in our sizing argument. Control D, add in the formula and change the sizing option to 2, which maintains the original image size, ignoring the cell boundaries. And here you see what has happened. It has brought the image in full size, which seems to be quite large to fit in our cell. It's like looking at a landscape from a tiny window and not being able to view the full picture. If we are to increase the column width like this and the row height too, then we'll be able to see it clearly. And we have arrived to Italy. Let's copy the formula from Germany, because if we do Control D now, it will copy the formula from UK and our image will be very large. Now we will choose the last sizing argument, which is 3. But with this argument, we also have to assign the height and width we want in pixels. So we put a comma after 3, and for height, since I'm not so sure about the image size in pixels, we put 500. There's one more thing here. If only one argument is mentioned between height and width, like in this case here, we have only mentioned height, Excel will resize the image maintaining the aspect ratio of the only argument provided. So we can finish the formula here, and I think we mentioned too high a value. Let's change it to 50. That's better. Now let's also add the width argument, let's say 100. And here we have the flag. So now you know how to use the image function in Excel with its various arguments. But this gets you images from the web. What about images that you have on your system already? Can we use them in the cells like these? Earlier, when we used to insert images from the Insert tab, Pictures, they used to be over the cells. But now we have two options here. Place in cell and place over cells. We are going in place in cells and we have three options here. This device, which is your computer. Then we have stock images, which are images from Microsoft to be used in office products by office customers. And lastly, we have online pictures, which are somewhat like Google images. But since it's the Microsoft world we are in, we have to use Bing images. But we are interested in images from our computer, so we choose this option and then navigate to a folder where the image is stored and bring it here like this. It's pretty small, so let's increase row height and done. You can also achieve the same result if you have merged some cells like this. Let's merge these cells from here from the Home tab, go back to our Insert tab, Pictures, In Cell, this device and select our image. And this looks better. But that's not all. Since these images are in a cell, you can do a lot with them. Move them by cut, copy and paste. You can sort them as we did earlier. And most important of all, you can use them in functions. Let me show you. Here I have the file from the salary sheet video where we created a salary sheet for our employees. If you haven't watched the video, check the top right and the description of the video for the link. Here we have our employee data and I have placed the photos of all the employees using the Insert tab. Now let's go to a salary slip. If you recall, all this data is tied to the employee ID. We are pulling all this data, the name, department, designation and all of these components of the salary using VLOOKUP from our employee ID. Let's add our photo up here where we already have merged some cells for company logo, phone and email. Let's delete them for now and write our VLOOKUP formula here. Our lookup value is employee ID, which is A9. Our lookup array is an employee data sheet here. So we select all from here all the way to here and our column index is 15, and we use 0 for our last argument and press enter. Here we have the photo in the salary slip. And it changes just like all the other details when you change the employee ID like this. These are just some examples I was able to show you. But the possibilities and ways that you can use this feature are totally up to you. You can use this in dashboards, customer databases, employee databases, spare part list, or any other list for that matter. How you're going to use it, I leave it to you. And with this, we have covered nearly everything for today. If you have any queries, suggestions, or feedback, jump to the comment section and spill your heart out. And when you are done with that, may I also interest you in liking this video, subscribing to my channel, and sharing this video to your friends and colleagues. Because you know, that'll be splendid. Until next time, happy spreadsheeting.